Hello everyone and welcome to this video. Now today I'm going to be doing a vinyl update video. So yeah, just showing some of the things I've got over the last couple of months. So this is just a random sort of like selection basically, like just from like various, like I think mostly for record shops. I don't think that there's any online purchasing, mostly for record shops or actually charity shops. Like I've like started like looking at a bit. Occasionally like you do find like some gems there. But yeah, I will just get started with the video. And first one I'm going to show was actually an online purchase. It is a new release by Andy Partridge. Now this did come out a couple of months back. I think it just missed the cutoff from like my last video. It's called My Failed Songwriting Career, and basically what it is after XTC kind of sort of ceased to be, like Andy Partridge kind of became a songwriter for other artists, and he'd get commissioned like to do songs, and like then like he'd write maybe say a selection of 10, and then he maybe be lucky like if like one or two of them like were actually covered. So he's got a huge mass of songs like which just haven't been released, so he's starting like to put them out like on like these sort of 4-track EPs here. So this is the first one, and I don't think any of the other ones have been announced yet. I'm like almost positive of that. Apparently like there is more to come like from these here. So this is just 4 tracks. I maybe would have preferred it had it been on like one whole sort of album kind of worth of songs. But then again, I guess with them being like 4-track EPs, you kind of it maybe gives you more of a chance to like appreciate the songs and sort of like get to know them like a little bit better. Because there's some, I mean off like the 4 songs here, all 4 of them are good, but certainly Ghost Train, which is the lead track on here, is fantastic. Brilliant song there. A real rocker that one. And Great Day is like a lovely kind of Paul McCartney like impression. So my Failed Songwriting Career by Andy Partridge here. Excited to pick up like the next ones in that series. Next up, just got a couple of singles here, which I bought when I was on holiday with my girlfriend a couple of months ago here. So I got this one here, Talking Heads one, which is for This Must Be The Place. This was £1. It's not in brilliant condition, but I'd never seen it before, like on 7-inch. It wasn't a big single, like out at the time. Although it's like a classic song now. This was never like a big seller, so it was quite fun to see this. And again, only for £1, so I picked that one up. And this one was a big seller. It's The Jam's Going Underground, but this was also £1 as well. So I might start collecting Jam singles. This is one of the first I have. I think I've maybe got one or two others, but they had a lot of singles out, like all in like lovely sleeves like this, and I might start getting those like as I went to see them. But I mean, this was £1, so I couldn't leave it behind, backed with The Dreams of Children. So yeah, fantastic single there. Okay, next batch come from when I went record shopping in Stirling, which is a sort of like a medium-sized sort of city like in Scotland here. And they've got a great record shop called Europa Music. I'd say it's probably one of the best record shops. Probably out one like the biggest ones like in Scotland. And like always come out like with like some great stuff. But these first two are actually from a charity shop, like just like round the corner from it, like 2 CDs here. So I picked up this, which is a copy of Elvis Costello's album Imperial Bedroom on CD. But this has a bonus disc, which is chocked full of kind of bonus tracks. So there's 23 bonus tracks there, ranging from sort of home demos like off the songs, B-sides, and like alternate versions as well. So a lot of content on here, and it's all really good. Like some of the versions are very different to like the ones like you know like on the actual album. So there's just a double CD. It's fallen out the other one there, but that's it there. So yeah, really nice, and I'd never seen like this copy before. Like I wasn't aware it was even out like on like double CD. Nice to see that one. And then the other CD was this album, Prefab Sprout. Now, I've slowly been getting into Prefab Sprout. I reviewed protest songs from a couple of months back, loved it, and I've recently kind of really got into the Steve McQueen album. But this is like the later one. It's called The Gunman and Other Stories. And this is from 2001 here. Quite late on, like in like the career, but it's more of a kind of, I guess it's kind of got a kind of country sort of flavour to it. I guess you can probably kind of kind of tell that much like, by like the cover and sort of like the title of it. So there's stuff on here which is, it's maybe not my usual style like of music, but there's some great songwriting still, and so I'm like, yeah, like just some like really like good songs. One I maybe do need to spend a little bit more time with, that, because I think I've only played it like the once, but like the once I did play it, I did really like enjoy it. So yeah, Gunman and Other Stories there by Prefab Sprout. Okay, now on to the records, which I got at Europa Music, and so I'll just begin with a couple of mostly was 12-inch singles I got, and the first four I think are all from the same artist. So I got a couple of they had a lot of Elvis Costello singles, so I'll just show the ones I got. Please Don't Let Me Be Misunderstood here, his cover of the old song. I know the Animals version but I even think that their version like was a cover like as well. So there's that one. This song, which I wasn't familiar with, I think it's on Blood and Chocolate, but I'm not 100% sure. It's Blue Chair. So yeah, someone correct me if I'm wrong, but like I'm almost certain this is on Blood and Chocolate. If not, it must just be a standalone single. And then the other ones were Let Them All Talk. Very 80s cover, this one here, from Punch the Clock album. And then this one, which is my favourite one, like, off the ones I picked up, it's Veronica, which is a fantastic song anyway. Yeah, it's a kind of like a collaboration like with Paul McCartney, which is great. But then this one also comes with a lovely poster, and I mean like a really nice poster. I mean, this would have made a much better cover of Spike than the one you actually got, I think. I think it looks really cool, like that poster there, Elvis Costello. That one was a little bit more. I think it was £4. I think all the other ones were at £2. So nice to pick those up. And again, I think they've all got like exclusive B-sides on them, so that's certainly like something there. So yeah, a couple of Costello singles. Okay, I also picked up this one here, which is by China Crisis. So I do generally quite like China Crisis. They're sort of like 80s kind of synth pop band. This is a song called Christian, which I believe this is, I think, might be their first single. Certainly one of like the very early ones, 1982 it says on here. Again, just on a 12-inch single. Was pretty cheap, and I just thought that I'd pick it up. I like the cover, and yeah, I really like the song. This is one now what I'd never seen before either, which I was like, yeah, I think I'm gonna get that. It is Difford and Tilbrook, so basically Squeeze, and it's a song, Love's Crashing Wave. So this was taken from a album which they made as a duo in 1984. So I think when Squeeze the band was kind of on like hiatus, Difford and Tilbrook made an album together. I don't know why they didn't just put it out like under the Squeeze name. But anyway, this was the main single from it, and yeah, like easily the best track like on the album. Nice artwork on that as well. So this was only £3 for something like which I'd never seen before. I thought I'm gonna get that. Next one now, a really underrated band, I think, from the 80s. It is The Colourfield here. So this band, mostly known for Terry Hall, who was in The Specials and Fun Boy 3. After Fun Boy 3 sort of split up, like he went on to form The Colourfield. And they've got, they only made the two albums. And to be fair, only one of those albums, Versions of Philistines, like is really worth checking out. That's a fantastic album. And this is a song from it, Castles in the Air. And I mostly love this cover though. The same sort of cover was used on their Greatest Hits album. I think it's really nice, like really classy look to it. And a fantastic song there. And again, like a good B-side, Your Love Was Smashing, which wasn't on the album. So yeah, that's The Colourfield and Castles in the Air. Next one up now, I can't believe like how cheap like this like really was, but it's not in brilliant condition though. It's a single, Electronics, Getting Away With It. So of course Electronic, and Bernard Sumner and Johnny Marr. This is probably like their most popular song, I would say. And yeah, when I see this for £3, I was like, wow, that's really cheap. It is a bit damaged on the back, you can see that there, but it's just a white cover anyway, so it's not that big a deal. I mean, it's not great, but I was like, usually this would go for at least a tenner, like if not more. So like I was like, yeah, like I think I'm I think I'm going to get that. I like the cover, and then you've got like an extended mix of it like as well, which I think is unique to this format. I don't think that's ever been issued on CD or kind of streaming services or like whatnot. So yeah, like a nice one to pick up here, electronic there and getting away with it. Next one now, another 12-inch single. It is by XTC and it's for Ball and Chain. Now, yes, I did show the 7-inch to this in my last final update video. But, I mean, it's XTC. They are probably my favourite band now. It's like, certainly up there for me. Definitely a top 5 band for me. And a band who I will probably collect everything off, you know, like if I ever see anything of theirs which I don't have, I'll more than likely pick it up. And like this was and this was the case of this. I mean, there's nothing exclusive on here which which you don't get with the 7-inch, although I'm actually thinking like that Cockpit Dance Mixture I don't think is on the 7-inch, but then again I don't think it's very much that sort of music wise. But yeah, a great single here from 1982's English Settlement album. So yeah, nice just to get a slightly bigger version of it here. So yeah, XTC, Ball and Chain. Okay, last two now from Europa Music, both albums here. Probably not from artists like who like I would like usually sort of buy stuff from. I think you'll be able to see why I bought these ones here. So first one is this ABBA album here. So if you don't know, I am a big fan of ABBA. They were my first sort of musical love, really. Like really, even before the Beatles and like whatnot. I've got a big soft spot like for ABBA. And this was an album of theirs which I was missing. I inherited like my mum's copies like of all their other albums, or well, most of the ones what came out like after this, but this is what she didn't have. It came out 75 and it's the album probably most known for. The songs Mamma Mia and Dancing Queen on here are the two highlights, but then there's some other good stuff like I've Been Waiting For You, like it's a lovely ballad, and I think Man In The Middle is a song which I quite enjoy as well. But there are still some kind of fillery tracks here, things like Tropical Love Land and like Intermezzo Number 1, which is kind of like a piano instrumental. So it's not a flawless album like by any means, but I think, yeah, like any album with Mamma Mia like and SOS on it like is certainly worth like your attention there. So no fancy design with this one here, but was only £8, so I thought, yeah, why not pick it up. So that's ABBA's self-titled album. And this next one, again, I wouldn't normally go for this, but it is an album. I do slightly remember this from my childhood a little bit. My dad used to have it on CD. I thought, like I seen it, it was fairly cheap, and I thought, okay, I'm going to get it. So it's Crosby, Stills and Nash here. They're self-titled. I think the first album, like I want to say, for this one here. This was, I think, before Neil Young joined them for like a couple like of albums. It says 73 like on the back, but I'm almost certain this is a later reissue because it was only £12, so I thought, yeah, like why not pick it up. Lovely gatefold to it, and it's maybe not the usual music like I would go for. A lot more kind of soft rock sort of 70s vibe, but there's some great tracks in here, like Sweet Judy Blue Eyes is fantastic. You've got Wooden Ships is great as well, and Marrakesh Express is like a fun song too. A lot of like good tracks here, and again, like I said, one I do remember from my childhood there. So that's Crosby, Stills and Nash. Okay, next few now are all taken from a record fair which was on a couple of weeks back. Just one of like the regular ones like which they have like every week, kind of like touring around like the country and that. I just decided to go along, and I got some really good stuff, so I'll just show them now. So first ones were from a seller who had some 7-inch singles. I think they were 50p each or 3 for a pound, so I thought, right, I'm gonna try and find 3 because the first one I saw was this, which is a Prefab Sprout. Again, like I said, been really getting into them. So this is Jordan, the EP, which came out in 1991, I think. Well, certainly, like I'd say around the same time the album came out. And it's basically just 4 songs out from the album, but I love the cover of it. And I was just like, yeah, I've got to have that. But then I was trying to then find 2 more ones to go along with it. And I got these two here. So I got one by 10cc, which I'd never seen before, a song called Feel the Love, which is one of like their later singles. It's not one of their finest songs, but I'd never seen it before, like on 7-inch, so I thought I'll pick that one up. And then the other one is by a band who I'm not too familiar with, but I know that I generally like them. It's James here. This is a song called Sound, backed with All My Sons there. I think one of like, their earliest singles came out in, if I could just get the year right, 1991. So I think this is from, well, if not the first album, certainly quite early in like their career. And yeah, so I thought, good introduction there, like to James. Like, I mean, like definitely like a band like who I need to like investigate some of like their albums. And one from a different seller here, but one again, I was quite glad to pick up. It is a Kate Bush single here. So this is for Running Up That Hill. I mean, recently been really getting into Kate Bush and been really enjoying like mostly like the Hounds of Love album, and that's what this song is from. So I was like, yeah, I've just got to pick it up. It's a lovely gatefold copy of it here, lovely artwork, and it even comes with its own little like inner sleeve there, the single. So this was a bit more pricey, it was a fiver, but I was like, yeah, I think it's worth it for that. So that's Running Up the Hill, and again, you've got an exclusive B-side called Under the Ivy, which I'd never heard of before. So yeah, that's Kate Bush and Running Up That Hill. Okay, now some more 12-inch singles here. So first one is by the Style Council. Yes, there is one of theirs which I didn't own. It is You're the Best Thing, or Groovin', like as it was called, but it's basically You're the Best Thing. Backs with a Big Boss Groove there. Yes, I didn't have this one like on 12-inch. I'm not sure why, I just never come across it. But yeah, like lovely cover off it. And yeah, fantastic song as well. So that was kind of like an obvious one to pick up like when I seen it. Staying with kind of Paul Weller related items, I've seen this one, which is by a band called The Questions. Now, these were a Scottish band who was signed on Paul Weller's own Respond Records label. And they didn't have all that much success, I think. This I believe was like the highest charting song called Price You Pay. I think they had another one called Tuesday Sunshine, which also charted, but I kind of got like the lower end like off the charts. They done an album and then they basically just dissolved, they didn't really have all that much success. But then interestingly, the songwriter guy like in the band, Paul Barry, went on to become a hugely successful songwriter like for other artists. He wrote that song Believe like for Cher. So he's certainly made like his fortune through like other means, like probably not so much through his time with The Questions, but they're really good. Yeah, very Style Council-y, really good stuff there. So that's The Price You Pay by The Questions. Next up, a lot newer, this item, it's by The Charlatans. It's an EP what was released a couple of years back, I think 2018, called Totally Eclipsing here. So it's one I just never picked up. I maybe just didn't really spark my interest too much. And I'd seen it come out, like, I was aware of it coming out, but yeah, I just never bothered getting it. I was quite glad to see this for a fiver, still in the shrink wrap like and everything, and it's on a lovely green vinyl too. So yeah, glad to get that one. Just another one to add to the Charlatans collection, Totally Eclipsing. Okay, and this next one, I did actually already have a copy of it, but it's not the one I really wanted. So when I seen this copy, I was like, I'm going to get that. It's New Order's Blue Monday here. Now, I have got the standard sort of black sleeve, like it's not got like the cutouts on it. But this, if I could just go get out of it, it's got this sort of, the iconic sort of die cut cover, which is very famously expensive like to make. I believe like they lost money every time they sold one of these, it's just a copy like of Blue Monday, like Monday, like I've already got the single. It's a classic song and you can't go wrong with it. So I was like, yeah, I could do with getting like another copy, and that was after like the die cut one too. Okay, now last thing from that record fair, and kind of sticking with sort of albums which I wouldn't normally go for, and like artists, yeah, like who like I, yeah, like probably like haven't like sort of like investigated much. I did get this album by Prince, which is 1999, and this was only £12, which I thought was a very generous price for it, like for like an original copy, like off it, like as well. So I was like, yeah, I think I'm gonna get that. I sense that's a real steal there. So it's a lovely copy in, yeah, fantastic condition. It's a double album, like as well, and it's got, as I said, it's got all the lovely like inner sleeves with it. It's got a promotional thing off all his albums today on it there. And yeah, just a lovely copy of it. As for what I thought of the album, maybe needs to grow on me a bit more. I'd say it's one of these albums where I guess I kind of probably need to be like in like the mood for it. A lot of the songs do sort of are quite loose and sort of go on a little bit. You know, they're not sort of succinct sort of pop songs and that. You know, a lot of them like are sort of very funky, sort of like kind of like sort of like 5-6 minute kind of jams and that. But yeah, it's something which I guess I could see myself appreciating more like as I like listen to it. But yeah, right now I'm still maybe a little bit like on like the fence with it. Okay, next batch now come from a record shop in Dunbar, which is a town maybe about half an hour away from me, just in kind of like, yeah, so like East Lothian, like in Scotland. It's a record shop like I've never been to before. I think it's been there for years. I just never like thought to visit it. But I did get some really good stuff from there. But first, a couple from a charity shop like in sort of like Dunbar sort of town centre itself. So got a couple of CDs. Each of these were £1. Didn't really need either of them, but I thought, you know what, like, why not, like, just get them. So it's first one is a Style Council Greatest Hits compilation. Basically just does what it says on the tin, just sort of collects like their singles and that. So yeah, maybe didn't need this one, but it is a nice one to have. I guess for like my car perhaps. The Style Council. And then another one, again £1, was The Beautiful South, Blue is the Colour. I have this one on vinyl like already, but maybe this is one like which I can kind of maybe use as like my playing copy of it, because the vinyl is like is quite rare and is what I guess I want to keep in as nice a condition like as I can. But yeah, fantastic record here. 1996 this one came out. And then also from that charity shop was this, Say, Paul McCartney and Michael Jackson. Again, another McCartney 12-inch, which I just didn't have. I just like never seen it before, really. I mean, this is only £2, and it's not in brilliant condition, this. But I thought, yeah, for £2, why not? Just pick it up. Again, you've got an exclusive mix, like, off it. Like which wasn't even on like the archive edition like of Pipes of Peace, like sort of like the 12-inch remix like off it here, and then Ode to a Koala Bear like is on the B side again, very hard to come by track there too. So that's Say, Paul McCartney, Michael Jackson. And then from the actual record shop itself, I got five items actually. First one was this another Kate Bush single here. This one for Cloud Busting, one of my favourite songs of hers. And again, you've got an exclusive B-side there called Burning Bridge. That's Cloud Busting. Then I picked up a Lloyd Cole single, again another 12-inch of his, which I didn't have. This one is for Perfect Skin here. And it's backed with songs called The Sea and the Sands and You Will Never Be No Good. Fantastic single, like his debut single, just a brilliant, brilliant song. Earlier I showed a China Crisis 12-inch single, and from this shop I got a album of theirs, which is Working With Fire and Steel, Possible Pop Songs Volume 2. Very, slightly pretentious title there, but good album here though, nonetheless. I believe this is their second album from 1983. Okay, and then the two main ones from that record shop are these here. So, first one is by a band called The Chills. Now, these are an Australian band. They're from the 80s, but this is their, I believe, their only album. And it's a kind of like a compilation sort of thing, like of singles and that. So I'd say like they're from New Zealand, and how I heard of them was through a House of Love B-side. The House of Love covered one of their songs called Pink Frost, and I guess for maybe for a few months just assumed it was a House of Love original. And then I kind of read, I saw like the credits, and I was like, oh, Guy Chadwick like didn't write this, wonder who did the original. Turns out it was the Chills, and their original version is almost identical to like the House of Love's version, like, to like be honest with you. But then, yeah, like I said, like I checked out this album and I really liked it. This is a reissue of it. So it's kind of like an expanded version. You've got a ton of information in there, a whole sort of write up like about the band, and then yeah, so I said like a double vinyl. So yeah, just on kind of slightly generic labels there, but yeah, fantastic band, definitely worth like checking out, like if like you're not like familiar with them. And yeah, this is a probably like I'd probably say like the only place to start with them. So it's called Kaleidoscope World this year by The Chills. Okay, and the final one from the Dunbar shop was this, which is The Chameleons, and an album called What Does Anything Mean, basically. So Chameleons were a Manchester band from the 80s, but they were never like sort of like as kind of mainstream, like as like the Smiths or like sort of like whatnot, like or Happy Mondays and that, you know. And they were a bit more, I guess, progressive. I mean, it's kind of, I guess, a bit gothy, like this album, but really good though, and just such a beautiful atmosphere, like on it, like I think. And this is an original copy of it, which I said I'd never seen before, and I was I just thrilled to pick it up. So that's what the gatefold looks like. They just got pictures of them, and then just some writing there, I guess, a poem or something there, like on like the inside. And the record itself is on, what label are we on? Static with a K, Static Records there. So that's, yeah, the Chameleons, What Does Anything Mean, basically. Okay, next, two are from a Oxfam charity shop, which is in Stockbridge in Edinburgh. It specialises like in music, so it tends to be good stuff like you find in there. Although, I mean, it's not the cheapest place, but I mean, like, they don't like rip you off either, like, to be fair. But like, anyway, like, I got two items from there. So I found this CD, which is by Guy Chadwick. So he was the frontman, like, of the House of Love. This is a solo album called Lazy, Soft and Slow. This came out in 1997, and I don't believe it's ever been put out on vinyl. So this is like my only copy of it, and it was only about, I think about £3. So I thought, yeah, I've got to get that. Like, if anything, like just to like own the album. Guy Chadwick there. And then I got this album, which again, another one which I wouldn't normally go for like this band, but they are highly regarded, and this is a kind of greatest hits kind of singles collection of theirs. So it's The Fall, and this is basically it's called 458489 A-Sides. Funny title, but basically just does what it says on the tin, a collection like off like their sort of like their singles basically. And they were never, I mean were they a singles band? Yeah, possibly, but like they didn't really have huge charting singles and that. But they did have some great songs like Hit the North, and like a good cover like of There's a Ghost in My House, and like Hey Luciani's like pretty good as well. So yeah, a lot of good stuff like on here, and that just details the history like of the band, and you've got all the tracks on it there. And the record here is on Beggar's Banquet Records. And as I said, like, I've seen this one, I've seen countless reissues of it, but this was a original of it, like, which I've seen, again, like, the Oxfam shop. So I was like, I think I'm going to get that. So that is The Fall and their singles. Next one now was a online purchase. It's actually a Record Store Day item, but, like, I wasn't sort of, like, too... I think it was a mix of, like, not being too enthused about, like, the sort of, like, the Record Store Day list this year. And also, like, I work Saturdays as well, so it would have been a bit tricky to kind of go to Record Store Day and then kind of head to work. So I gave it a pass this year. But then I did see this... I did see this album like advertised like on eBay for I think £15, so it was cheaper than I would have got it like on Record Store Day. So like I'm kind of glad I waited on it. It's Tom Petty and Angel Dream. Now essentially what this is a kind of reworked version of the She's the One soundtrack. So there's some tracks which cross over. Most of this is on the She's the One album, but there's I think 3 or 4 exclusive songs to this album which have never been sort of issued, and kind of like his lovely artwork as well, like I have to say. I mean, this is just a much better cover than She's the One. Beautiful picture of him there, like on the back. And this is on a blue vinyl, like I believe. So you just got all the lyrics there to the tracks. And then the record, yeah, just on a blue vinyl here. So yeah, that's Tom Petty there and Angel Dream. Okay, you'll be glad to know that we're on to the last 4 items here. All these were from when me and my girlfriend went down to York just last week, so very recent pickups, these ones here, all from charity shops in York. So the first 2 are CDs, the first one I'll show is this, which is a beautiful South CD single. This is from the song Perfect 10. This is £1, and I was like, yeah, I have to get that. It's a beautiful South, again, one of my favourite bands, one I'm probably going to try and collect as much as I can, like, off them. I just thought, yeah, I have to get that one. And the other one was this, which I'd never seen before, like, on CD. Did I really need it? Probably not, but it is a Paul McCartney one. It's a Standing Stone, which is one of his kind of classical albums. So again, very different from what like I would normally listen to, but it's Paul McCartney, so I'm like, yeah, I kind of have to get that. And I mean, because it was about £2 or £3 this, so I was like, yeah, I kind of have to get that. I'll just try to get out the little booklet to kind of show you, but it's very tight in here, so I don't think I'll bother. But Standing Stone there, like, lovely artwork to it though. It's just a sort of nice kind of calm sort of classical album. And 2 vinyl records from the charity shops. First one is this album by Madness. It's Complete Madness. So I must say, like, I like some Madness songs, but I'm not a huge fan of theirs. I don't have any other albums. This is kind of like my sort of first album. I think for like a lot of people, this is the kind of like the first one like they get. This basically just collects out their singles. Like, up to this point, because I think it's, Our House, like, isn't like on this album, I don't think. So that must have just come out after this was released, or like otherwise it's just a massive like omission like from here. I'm almost certain that would have come out after this, otherwise it would have been included here. But then you've still got things like My Girl, Baggy Trousers, House of Fun, One Step Beyond, Grey Day. So a lot of well-known, like well-regarded hits on here. And yeah, like lovely artwork like to boot as well. So Complete Madness. Again, was only very cheap, this one, so I was kind of like, yeah, have to get that. And final one I'm going to show in the video today is an album which I've been looking for quite a while now. It's the first album from Joe Jackson. It's called Look Sharp, and not an expensive, not a rare album, but just one I'd had trouble coming across, because it's probably my favourite album of his. It's got songs like Sunday Papers, Is She Really Going Out With Him? Yeah, just some really good sort of sharp songs on here. I had a hard time trying to find it, but then seen it, yeah, I think for about £3, like in like a charity shop. So I was like, God, I have to get that. I mean, it's not in brilliant condition. There's a bit like that was already on it, and a bit of ring wear like on like the back too. And I mean, I'm not sure like if it had like a custom sleeve of it originally, but this is just like a plain sleeve, so it's not the best copy like I could have got. But considering like I'd never seen it before, like on vinyl, I was kind of like, yeah, I sort of like I have to get this one now. The time has come. That's Joe Jackson there, and Look Sharp. So yeah, that's me come to the end of this vinyl update video. So I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have any sort of suggestions like for album reviews or whatnot, please do leave them down below. I mean, it might be quite slow sort of like getting to them, just because, yeah, like uni work, and I guess I've kind of got out of the habit like of making videos like as regularly like as like I once did, but like I'm gonna try and like keep up like with them. If there's any reviews of that, please do leave them like down below, like in like the comments. And yeah, I will see you all next time for the next one. Goodbye. When I go to all the parties down my street, I wash my hair and I kiss.